All right, so let's take a look at creating foundation walls. So looking at my project that I have open here, I'm going to go to my project browser, and you'll see I'm in my foundation plan. So what I did for the purpose of this demonstration is I just laid down some reference planes to give me the bulk shape of the building that I'm working on. That way I can quickly go through and lay down the foundation walls with respect to the reference planes. So I'm going to have two different types of foundation walls. I'll have the outline here, and then I'll have a shallow foundation and a deep foundation. So the first thing that you want to do is you want to, of course, go into an elevation view, and this is going to help you establish the height of these foundation walls. So for this application, which is a residential application, I'm going to have a deep foundation, which is going to be underground as well. And you can see my first floor is currently set at 0, and my foundation is 1 foot below that. And my basement will have a height of negative 8 feet 10 and a half, and then my footings, the top of my footings and bottom footings, will be directly below that. So essentially what I want to do is I want to start drawing from the level or the plan foundation and draw having a depth going to top of footing. So that's where I'm going to start. I'm going to open up foundation now, and I have these reference planes here, so I can start drawing foundation walls a number of ways. I can start from the structure panel or the structure tab and go to the structure panel and go wall structural, or I can go to the architecture tab and wall and go wall structural. Either way is just as effective. Since I'm already here, I'm just going to use the architecture tab. And so once I select that tool, you'll notice I'm going to go to my type selector. I'm going to choose the type of foundation wall I want to use. So currently I have foundation 10 inch. That's about it. So for me, I want to use an 8 inch foundation wall. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go edit type, and I'm going to duplicate this one, and I'm going to give it a new name, and I'm going to change this from 10 inches to 8 inches. Select OK, click edit here beside structure, and I'm going to change this from 10 inches to 8 inches. Okay, everything here is okay. Now this wall will be 8 inches. Good. So now I'm ready to start drawing. The next thing you want to look at is in your options bar. You can look at the options bar, or you can look at the properties palette. But for me, I'm going to look at the options bar. And it's asking me for my location line. So this is the width of the wall with respect to your cursor. So do you want your cursor to be justified on the center of the wall, or do you want it to be on the exterior face or interior face? So for me, I'm going to use, let's say finish face. Well, because there's only one core face interior and finish face interior or exterior would be the same face. So I'm going to use core face exterior. And I'm not going to draw it. Now, Revit's given me some default values here. I'm going to draw this with a depth rather than a height. So my base constraint is going to be, I already said it's going to be top of footing. And I don't want a base offset. It'll be 0. And up to, my top constraint will be up to foundation. So once I move my cursor in place, you can see that my options bar says that it's going to be an 8'2" wall. Location line remain the same. Just for my depth, top of footing, that's correct. So now I'm ready to start drawing this foundation. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go in here. I can actually use the sketching tools, or I can use pick lines. For me, I think I'm just going to stick with the sketch lines and see how this pans out. So you can see everything is actually visible. Everything's visible, so that's good. If you ever get an error saying it's your elements are not visible, then something's wrong with your view range or your element visibility. So everything seems to be going okay for me here. Just going to keep clicking, and you'll notice that I'm actually picking, my cursor is justified on the exterior face of the wall, and that's because of my location line there. So if that was center justified, then my cursor would be located in the middle with respect to the width of the wall. All right, so that's been closed, and now you'll notice once I complete the chain, the wall or the command actually ends. I'm still in the command, so I could keep going if I wanted to. I'm just going to select modify here, and then I'm going to navigate to this default 3D view. Can take a look at what that looks like. So here is my foundation. I have, you can see it has a concrete texture applied to it. It has a depth. It's going to be below grade because that's how where I sent it in my elevation. So let's take a look here. Going to the basement. It's hard to see. Okay, there it is. So you can see it there. It starts at the top of foundation, and it actually goes down to the top of footing level, which is correct. That's exactly where I want it. And then the basement level is where I'm going to have my slab. The bottom of my slab will sit on top of that. And that's how we draw foundation walls using Revit.